everyone. My name is Amy, and welcome to Glencairn's Great Hall. This space is awesome. We are surrounded by medieval stained glass windows. Now, some of these are modern copies of medieval windows, but just up here behind me, there are real medieval windows set right into Glencairn's wall. Today, we're going to take a close look at two small round windows just up here behind me. These are called medallions, and originally they would have been part of a rose window, which would have had many more medallions as part of its design. They're a little over 800 years old, and they're originally from northern France. Let's start at the bottom, where we can see a man standing wearing green and yellow, and just next to him are the letters V-E-R, ver, which is Latin for spring. He's holding two objects that also symbolize spring or new life. In one hand, he has a palm leaf, and in the other, he's holding a nest with little birds in it. Now, this is kind of unusual for a window representing spring. Usually, the person would be holding a flowering branch. In some rose windows, there's a whole calendar of all the seasons, summer, winter, fall. I wonder what objects those people were holding in their windows. If we look above to the second medallion, we can see on one side is a woman seated wearing a blue cap and a white collar. Now, in medieval art, usually women were depicted with their hair covered, which is how we can tell that this is a female figure. And next to her is a boy also seated wearing a white shirt and purple tunic. She's holding a stick and he's holding a book. And this is actually a picture of grammar. Things like punctuation and spelling, the stuff we use when we read and write. Now, today we don't really think of grammar as a picture, mostly just a subject you might learn at school. But in the Middle Ages, it was one of the seven liberal arts that all students would learn, which also included things like math, music, and astrology. So in this window, grammar is the teacher, and her student is sitting diligently learning from his book. Both of these windows show something personified. That just means using humans to show an idea that isn't human, like spring or grammar. You might be able to think of some ways that we still do this today. For example, the Statue of Liberty uses a woman to represent the idea of freedom. This helps people feel a little more connected to art and objects, and is something that artists have used for a very, very long time. Now, if you're interested in learning more about the symbols of medieval stained glass and cracking the code to hundreds of years of history, you might be interested in coming to take our stained glass program. You can visit glencairnmuseum.org to learn about how to book your program and also to find all of the fun and exciting resources we have for you to explore.